The decision to study abroad is the best decision I have ever made in my life.
In the middle of nowhere,
my name is Tinh Pham. I'm from Vietnam. I want to get outside my country to learn about the world. So that's why I decided to study abroad.
Мне нравится быть иностранным студентом, потому что к иностранным студентам другой подход. От иностранного студента ждут других идей и других мнений, нежели от американского студента. И мне это нравится. Я думаю, что американские студенты тоже, им тоже бы понравилось, побывав в Азии, увидеть, что к ним был бы другой подход. Какие плюсы в этом? Тебе повышенное внимание. Минусы, я бы тоже сказал, тебе повышенное внимание, потому что ты должен оправдывать то, что ты сюда приехал, и то, что ты достоин того, чтобы сюда приехать.
It was really hard for me the first time when I first came here, because, you know, my English was not that good. And even though I could speak, I could write, I could read, I could listen to people, but the English that we learn in school was totally different from what I encountered when I first came to Philadelphia. I basically had to learn everything all over again in order to communicate with people. And people on the street do not use academic English to speak with you, you know? They're gonna use like very informal English.
Yeah, I heard
and I do not know them. When I came here in the US, I had no idea what's up needed. And people would call me and I'd go, "What's up?" And I was like, "I'm going to somewhere." I thought that they asked me, "Where are you going? What are you doing?" Something. I did not know how to reply. And later on, I found out that it was just a greeting. And people, you know, people walk on this, and there are other aspects to it, like, you know, cultural differences. For example, in Vietnam, when you see somebody, if you want to greet them, you just have to nod your head and make eye contact, or you can just smile with them. Here in the US, people would like ask you, "How are you?" or "Hi, hello." They would not like nod their head like this. And for most of the cases, when they ask you, "How are you?" they don't really expect you to like give a detailed answer. Whether how you feel today and what's going on, they do not really expect you to do like a pretty complicated job in reporting your condition to them. They would just ask, "How are you?" Just a very general statement. And as I understood when I first came here, I would give them, you know, a very very intense report of myself. How am I feeling? What has been going on? And usually, it becomes really awkward. Yeah, it became really awkward.
My name is Chepkej Ksenia. Chepkej is my last name, actually. And Americans have problems with my pronunciation of my name. It's okay. You just can call me K. My native language is Russian. And I guess I can speak two more languages. English and Japanese. It is difficult for me to study English just because I have to write papers to read these really difficult articles like American students do, but it's so difficult. And of course, professors did me a favor, a little favor, just because it's impossible in political studies to understand everything from the first time and to work like American students, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
If I forgot something like that right now, I can just show it, like dog, tuk, run, and crazy clown. I don't know, different weird stuff. Yeah. Oh, can I use bad words here? One time we went to the Target and I need to buy stuff for my room, and I asked our friend, American girl, she helped us with all this stuff. I asked, where is this shit? I need shit. And she was so confused. Yeah, and then I was talking about Cuba and
Cuba.
I'm so sorry, Cuba. Is it okay if I'll tell bitch? Okay. And I told something like, in Cuba, there are so beautiful beaches. Not like beaches, but beaches. It was just so confusing. I'm so sorry. America, I'm so sorry.
You know, people tell jokes, and I just don't understand. What are you gonna do when you don't understand jokes? You just smile, right? You just smile. Because the other people are smiling, but you have no idea what's going on. And if they ask you, what do you think? You would like, I don't really understand. Sometimes it's become really awkward. It's usually because of, you know, the common background knowledge. The background knowledge that they have and you have. Well, you have a totally different background of knowledge when they have a totally different background of knowledge. And when they tell jokes, usually they would refer to their common background knowledge. And you don't understand because you do not know that. Mm-hmm. You know, the American people usually make jokes about politics, for example. And if you do not know that figures, that political figures, it's really hard to get what's going on.
За три месяца учебы здесь я выучила два слова. Awkward moments. Потому что их очень часто. Он мне, да хера здесь awkward моментов! Я задолбалась. Когда ты говоришь, please, can you repeat your question? И не понимаешь. Это ужасно. Сейчас большинство пар ведутся на английском языке. И, ну, пока очень тяжело, потому что у меня большой языковой барьер. Вот. У меня начинается паника, когда со мной начинают разговаривать на английском. Вот, это тяжело. Я, конечно, стараюсь, но паника меня задолбала.
Конечно, иногда бывает тяжело участвовать в дискуссии, потому что пока я, допустим, обдумываю идею, проговариваю ее в своей голове на родном языке, потом перевожу, уже обычно эта идея сразу кем-то другим выплескивается. И иногда, конечно, это тяжело, но с другой точки зрения, я все-таки не так много участвую в дискуссиях, сколько я люблю задавать вопросы лично преподавателю вне учебное время. И это, я считаю, что это компенсирует какие-то, может быть, языковые препятствия.
That's a problem for international students, you know. If you come from the same country, you speak the same language, you share the same cultures, it's more likely that you're gonna stick with the group. You're gonna stick to the group. And at first, I got that tendency too. Even though I was kind of different from my friends, from my Vietnamese friend, that I try to get out of the group. There's always something there to pull you back, you know. Because it's like a comfort zone. You want to stay in your comfort zone. You don't want to get out and have a lot of weird moment with people when you don't understand people and people don't understand you. You definitely try to avoid those occasions. So that's a wonderful problem, yeah. I find it easier making friends with international students. Actually here in Bar, there are not many Vietnamese students. So I make a lot of friends. I make friends with a lot of international students instead.
Just a little bit caught in the middle. Life is a maze, love is a riddle. I don't know how to go. I need Russian people. I don't know. It's a difficult question. I just don't have time to think about it. I guess I told you that it is just impossible for me to imagine my life here without you, without other Russian friends. Because still Americans are different from Russians. I don't feel like... I mean, we have different culture, different literature, political issues, history. I don't really know what to talk about Americans. Okay, we will discuss our relationships, pop singers, and what next? I mean, I know a lot about American culture, but sometimes I just need to talk about something Russian.
It's just easier, it is easier to hang out with people who have similar interests. And, I mean, part of it too was, I have to say, a language, maybe not a language barrier, but everyone in our group didn't speak Russian. I mean, I speak a little bit of Russian, but it was just easier to be with people who are more fluent, I guess. Mostly, the American students hung out with each other, and then the, I guess, other students were very close. I really did like my roommates a lot, but we just didn't really do things together, because the American students would always want to go out and go to clubs or, you know, do crazy things, I guess, and the girls that I lived with didn't really have any interest. I mean, I know it was different. One of my friend Hannah lived with a few other girls who actually ended up starting to come out with us. But I don't know. Cultural differences. I mean, I guess I would say the biggest difference is that we had more interest in, I suppose, drinking, or I wouldn't say partying, but we would like to go dance late at night, and the other girls preferred to stay home and, you know, just kind of socialize amongst themselves.
The other thing is, it's not only because of us, but also because of the American students too. You know, it would be very easy for them to communicate within themselves, to cooperate within themselves. Maybe they also do not really reach out to us. It's just a feeling that I have. We have a common experience that, you know, we're coming from a faraway place. Mm-hmm. We come here in the US and we step into a totally different, not totally different, but a very different culture. And we share the same shocks, we share the same experience of traveling far away from home, studying in a different country, and, you know, we understand what problems we have, what difficulties we have. So possibly that common experience link us together.
Yeah, first it was difficult for me to adapt American culture, because it's a little bit different from Russian. I mean, we don't usually speak about sex, but first when I came to class, we started talking about gender and sexuality. I was so confused. I was just red, like Omar.
I had so many strange experiences too. Like, one of the most interesting, this really has nothing to do with it, but one of the most interesting things I saw was going into, we weren't in Karakol, we were on the eastern side of Issyk-Kul. Why had we gone out? We had gone out there to go for a hike, and we were staying in some hotel or hostel, and we were in a little village, like, I guess not supermarket, you wouldn't call it a supermarket, just a little store where they sold like alcohol and some food. And we went in there to get water before our hike, and this little girl who was probably 4 years old came in and bought a bottle of vodka from the vendor, and I'm assuming it was to take it home for her parents, but I guess it's just like that, those small nitpicks, because in the United States, like,
don't be like me.
you imagine like a 4-year-old girl be like, okay, my dad asked me to bring home a bottle of vodka, here's the money, can I take, you know, that wouldn't happen here. But there, I guess it's just those small communities, and I don't know, just it was so different.
So if you ask me, is it good to study abroad? I think yes. It's a chance to step outside of your comfort zone and maybe just look back and refine what you have, or actually to adapt to new things. It's a very good thing. Good experience.